Good morning, everyone, and welcome to today's installment of Atma Network webinar series. Today, we bring a very interesting session on crowdfunding for all our partners. The session is being presented by Ms. Ayushi Doshi. Ayushi is a leading nonprofit campaign manager at Ketto and manages fundraising for hundreds of nonprofits very closely. Crowdfunding is becoming more and more relevant in today's times, where organizations are using this facility to raise funds to meet their organization's objectives. She has a bachelor's in technology from NMIMS College, Mumbai, but she has been fundraising socially for the past 1.5 years. Ayushi has successfully helped organizations raise over 2 crores for causes that she is passionate about. But before we start the crowdfunding session, we would like to introduce you to what Atma Network is all about. Please watch this video.
Often a lack of resources and expertise prevent even the most high potential organizations from maximizing their impact. The Atma Network aims to provide strategic support to such organizations and social enterprises at a click of a button. Since 2007, Atma has worked with more than 50 NGOs in Mumbai and reached out to more than 80,000 beneficiaries. Through our experience, we have assembled a large collection of useful how-to guides, templates, readings, best practices, and examples. Enough material to create an NGO self-help library. And you get all of this for free. With Atma Network, you will understand at what stage your NGO is at present and which of the 10 organizational developmental areas you must focus on in order to become bigger, better, and stronger. Our hope is that by giving young NGOs access to this information, they can become more autonomous and accelerate their own growth. Interested in checking out the network? Sign up today and get started.
And now on to the session on crowdfunding.
The names of all the donors have been displayed. Now the best part about this is the donors sometimes like to be acknowledged, right? So when it, you know, it makes them feel better if their names are appearing in one of the donor list as one of the donors. Also, others who are making a donation will be able to see, okay, that there are, for this particular case, there are suppose 40 donors. Okay, there are 40 donors, and I'm sure this must be a genuine campaign. And it gives them more confidence to donate. They don't really give it a second thought, right? So this is what a basic crowdfunding campaign looks like. So I have just put up a description for all of them for you all to read it out later. Next is how microsite can support peer-to-peer crowdfunding. Now first I'll be explaining what is peer-to-peer fundraising, right? So this is like, if you have a project which is going to cost you a lot, you break that larger fundraising goal into smaller goals. Okay, meaning if you want to raise 10 lakhs, okay, instead of having one campaign of 10 lakhs, you can have multiple campaigns with smaller goal amounts each. Like you can have 10 campaigns and Harika goal amount is 1 lakh, okay? Now for all these 10 campaigns, the campaigners will be different. The campaigners can be anybody from the NGO team or anybody who is a supporter of the NGO, who is a regular donor, anybody who you think has a good network, friends, family, anybody can be a campaigner for your NGO, okay? Now, for example, I'm one of the supporters for Atma. Let's take an example. And I have a campaign assigned to myself, which has the goal amount as 1 lakh. What I'll do is, I'll try to raise that 1 lakh goal amount from my own network, okay, my friends, my family and everything, and I'll try to reach to that goal amount. Now, if Atma is trying to do the same thing to my network, it will not be able to do because nobody knows who the person is, who the campaigner is. They might not even know Atma, but when they know me, that okay, this is Ayushi's campaign and she wants to raise funds for this NGO, that is what they care about, that this is my campaign and that's why I can make a donation to it. Okay, so it makes a big difference. And when you're doing it through peer-to-peer fundraising, you tap so many different networks. Like if you have 10 different campaigns, you tap 10 different networks indirectly, which only one single campaign cannot really do, right? And you, of course, pull in more donors from your network, from your supporters and donors also. So it just keeps increasing your donor database. Okay, now that is the same thing which is shown in this picture. Without peer-to-peer fundraising, it's just the three donors which you have. And with peer-to-peer fundraising, these donors or these supporters, they have pulled in few more donors. That's the entire concept behind it. Now, what is a microsite? Microsite is provided by Ketto. It's basically a dedicated landing page that we give in order to support peer-to-peer fundraising. I'll show you all how. Now, this page, can you all see? This is for Teach for India. Okay, this microsite is for Teach for India. The banner image that you can see, this banner image of kids, it has been provided to us by them only. There is this button, Start a Fundraiser, the blue button. Okay, so wherever there is a supporter or anyone who wants to start a campaign for Teach for India, they can just come on this blue button, they can click on it, register themselves, create a campaign. A campaign will be created under their name. Okay, so all these campaigns that you see, so there are actually a lot of campaigns, more than 600 campaigns here, but here you can see only four campaigns in the screenshot. All these campaigns are created by all the fellows of Teach for India. Now I'll tell you what's the case with them. Now Teach for India have fellows who, and when they join the NGO, they have a few bunch of students or a classroom that they have been assigned. Okay. And the fellows have to teach the students, and you know, they have to do different activities with them. Now, when they join the NGO, Teach for India, they already, Teach for India makes sure ki wo unko apne orientation mein hi, they tell them about what is crowdfunding and how they can go about it and what is Ketto. They tell all of that to all the fellows. So what happens here is, here the campaigners are all the fellows. All these campaigns that you can see, they are all created by the fellows who have joined Teach for India, and they can raise funds for their own classrooms, for their own students. For example, if I'm one of the fellows and I feel like one of my my classroom needs to go to a trip on go for a trip to some museum, or they need to learn music maybe, so for that I will create a campaign for them. Okay, from this microsite only, I'll go to this microsite, click on the Start a Fundraiser button, create a campaign. I'll say that my students need to learn music, and this is what I'm doing for them. This will be the cost breakup of the, this is how much the teacher's instructor is going to charge. This is what we require for the musical instruments. All of that will be included in the about the fundraiser section. And I will create this campaign, share that within my own network, and try to raise funds for my students. So over, I think they have been with us for more than 2 years, I think, and they've ended up raising 1.2 CR almost, right? So, okay, yeah, that was one Teach for India's case study. The next one is the Nudge. Now, this is actually a very interesting thing that they have done. They have this thing called a 21-day challenge, right? Where every participant, they have to create a fundraiser, and along with that, they have to pick up an activity, right? This activity can be anything like, you know, having just two meals a day or 1,000 steps a day. And this activity needs to go on for 21 days. All right. Now, when they are raising funds, they need to follow this activity for 21 days also. So it's not very monotonous that they have to just keep sharing the campaign and they have to raise funds. They have to do this activity also along with that. So they don't think that this is boring. It keeps them motivated, and they're doing something really healthy for themselves also. Right. So it was a really good way to keep all the, you know, the campaigners and the other supporters very motivated, and they ended up raising so much through that through the 21-day challenge that they had conducted. They still have it actually. You can actually visit their website and check it out. It's a really nice thing. The next case is Upai. Upai is also one of the nice NGOs that we have on board. Here the case is very simple. The multiple campaigns that have been created, it has been created by the board members of the NGO itself and few other volunteers, I think. And they ended up raising so much in just, I think, less than 45 days. Yeah, and these volunteers, I think also some of them were a part of IIT Kanpur alumni group. Right. Okay, the next one is the next topic is also very similar, but this is how you can leverage your institutional relations with your NGOs and everything. Right. So here it is basically that we will help you, make use of it, leverage your relation with them. You know, we can pitch like very quirky and very creative ideas to all the HRs of any institution if you have like a partnership with them, and we can tell them to do a fundraising activity within the organization, right? Because the HRs are already looking for such things to do, and you know, a social they get attached to like a social cause, right? So it's always a nice thing to pitch it to the HRs if you have any partnerships with any corporates, right? So the first case that we have, the first one is Barclays. Here the case is very simple. Barclays have like a lot of NGOs who have been associated with them, and here the campaigners, the one who are raising funds, are either the Barclays employees or some teams from Barclays. It could be like the finance team, it could be other teams, it could be the BD team, any team. And they have raised funds for multiple NGOs who have been associated with them. And they ended up raising about 19 lakhs, right? The next case is UNI. UNI has been raising funds with us for two and a half years, and every year they raise funds for only about 2 to 3 months. Like last year they were having this fundraising activity for 2 to 3 months and they stop, and then they stop. Then again next year they do the same thing for 2 to 3 months and then they are done for the entire year. So here they have like partnerships with colleges. What they do is they end up, pitching this to colleges who they have partnered with and make every student create a fundraising campaign, okay? And they have like a fundraising challenge amongst the students, and they have incentives for them that if you are, if you raise above a certain amount, this is what you get, or this is what you get. Whatever incentives, that is actually for the NGOs to decide, but that is what you and I have done, and they ended up raising so much over 2.5 years of time. They had last year and the year 2018-2019, they had about 1800 volunteers, doing that for them. And they make sure whenever these students are actually, going to raise funds for them or doing this fundraising activity, any employees or any college students, they make sure all of them know about how they need to go about it, how they need to share, what they need to do, what content needs to be put up on the campaign. Everything is done. So this page that you are able to see here, the Hero App one, you can see only 4 campaigns here, but actually there are 1800 campaigns that are there on this page, and the cumulative amount that they have raised is so much, right? The next case is the Podar School. This is a very simple case. The NGO Mumbai First, they have an association with Lilavati Podar High School, and they created only one campaign, and they raised funds from all the students, meaning all these students made small donations, okay? And the ticket size was very small. That's the very important part actually about this particular case study. Even though the ticket size was small, the number of supporters were huge. So it was not a burden on the students also. and it was easy for them to raise funds through so many students. And yeah, so that's about it. They ended up raising 7 lakhs, and it is, you know, always beneficial to have such a partnership with a school or college, because every year the batch of students keep changing. So you can have the same activity with this different batch of students every year, because they are different. The entire donor base is different, so you can do it every year. So you are very relieved that, you know, you have a particular set of donations that are already going to be flowing in, and apart from that, you can be doing other different activities to bring in new donors, right? So that was the case with this school. Now, next is the donor management tools. Now, Ketto will be providing you with a dashboard. So this is a dashboard that you can see when you log into your, when you register your NGO on Ketto, and when you log in on our website, this is what you'll be able to see. These are all the features that we provide you. The first one is the contact section. Okay. Now, the NGOs might have a lot of contacts. They are not necessarily donors. They could be any lead. If you want to pitch any kind of ideas to any institutions, any schools, any colleges, any events you want to do, you can have a contact list for all of them. Like, you can store all the contacts here. You can add contact with this blue button. You can upload a CSV file also. If there are 500 contacts that you want to save, you can upload a CSV file for that. And you can also download these contacts from this database. So all the contacts are stored in one place, and it is easy for you all to, you know, get access to it. You can say, you can even enter the cities for each one of them. Okay, so this is the contact section. The next one is the donor listing. Now, whenever you have campaigns and you have donors who have made donations, you get the donor details for each contact. The donor name, the contact number, the amount that they have donated. Everything you get in the donor detail thing, so that you can send them regular updates. You can send them emails. You can send them thank you emails. Send ATG receipts, everything. That, and it is, you know, it is very necessary to for you all to retain this, maintain this donor data, because you need to send across communication to your donor. It's very important for you to retain them in the future. Like, agar, suppose aapka ek project hai, theek hai, abhi, and you ended up raising 5 lakhs for that through 200 different donors. Theek hai? Once your project is over, you send thank you email to them and tell them that, hey, thank you so much for making a donation. This is how we have utilized it. Okay. Then after a few months, like after 1 or 2 months, you send them like an emailer, like a normal emailer or anything. Then next time again, when you have a project, you can send them an email again that, hey, thank you so much for making a donation to a previous project. This is what we have. We are looking to do the next time. And it would be great if you could make a donation to this one also and support this project as well. So now what happens here is you are building donors' trust while you're sending them all the emails and updates and everything. You're not losing touch with them, right? So the donors tend to, you know, maybe trust you, and that is why they would probably end up donating. Not every donor will do it, but a lot of them will end up donating on a campaign. So it is very necessary for you to maintain a particular set of donors. And apart from that, for every project, you can be doing other things for getting and pulling in more donors. But this is very important, and you cannot do it unless you have the donor information, right? The next one is the automated ATG receipts. Now, for NGOs who have ATG already, and for NGOs who do not, will of course be applying for it in the future, right? So most of the NGOs that I know have been handling like a lot of NGOs, and most of them, they have been sending like separate emails to each donor. They have been sending it manually through post, you know. So instead of doing that, which is you know, consuming your time, your money, your everything. You can have, you can see this form, right? ATG receipt form. You can fill up your ATG details once here, just once, okay? And then you will be done. When you click on save, and when you opt for sending an ATG receipt to your donors, you can send it. This is what the format will look like, the template. And here, when you click on this select recipient, you can add the recipients. You can add the donors according to their locations, whether they have, how much they have donated. You can select all of those filters, and accordingly you can send them the ATG receipts. Okay, next to next one is the CRM, the email and the SMS tool. Now for the emails and SMS, whenever you want to connect with any of your donors, you want to send them emails, you or non-donors also, and any SMS, you can do it through this dashboard. You can select the header, the topic, the subject. You can select the email body and the SMS content, body, everything, and you can select the donors according to the type. They could be donors, non-donors, city, ATG sent, not sent, the donation range, everything. Now you can, the best part here is you can send unlimited emails and SMSs to all your contacts, donors, whatever, in a day's time. That you can't really do manually, because Gmail also has a particular limit, and even your phones, if you are doing it manually, it has a limit to what to what you can send an SMS, right? But through this CRM suite, you can do it unlimited. Okay, the next one is the progress update. I was talking to you all about how you can send the updates to all the donors who have been donated on that, who have donated on that particular campaign. So this is where you can do it from the back end. This is where you need to type the update title, the type of update that you've made it happen. You know, you have different options here, but you've made it happen, or you know, require more funds or whatever, and you can type in the content accordingly, right? So this was the backend this was the entire dashboard. Now when you click over here, on this slide over here, on the fundraiser section, you will be able to see. Now this is a dummy. This entire thing is a dummy demo dashboard that we have on Ketto. Okay, this every NGO will get. So this is an NGO account. You can say that this is an NGO account. So us NGO ke liye whatever fundraisers have been created, you can see it over here in the fundraiser section. Okay, now this fundraiser will also have a little dashboard which will help the NGOs a lot. I'll tell you all how. Okay, so this is one thing, share impact. Okay, so what happens here is whenever you're sharing your campaigns, okay, and your donors or your supporters or anybody ends up sharing your campaign with their own network by sharing it on Facebook or wherever, you can track that. Okay, name of the person who has shared it, how many times they have shared it, and the amount that they have bought in when they have shared the campaign. All of this is tracked. Okay, and you get all of this information, so you can probably send them like a thank you email. Hey, thank you so much for sharing. Your share has brought in so much donation, or whatever, you know, it only makes them feel better. So it's important for you to do these kind of things, and you can do it only when you have this data. The next one is remind to donate. Now there might be times when you're sharing a campaign, people might come on it, they will do some activity, like they'll click on the donate button to see what's going on, what is there. They might make a comment, they might ask for an update, whatever, any activity that they do, their details get captured, the email IDs get captured. And when you click on automate reminder for them, an email goes out to these people reminding them to make a donation every 3 days. Okay, so there can be a possibility na ki wo aapke campaign page par aaye, they came onto your campaign page but they did not make a donation because probably they were getting they were busy doing something else, they got busy doing something else or anything. So this is for that particular reason that you can send them automated emails for reminding them to make a donation. The next one is analytics. Here you'll be able to see what social medium is working the best for you. Is it Gmail? Is it Facebook? Is it WhatsApp? Here, this particular case study that I'm showing you, it is only for Gmail and Facebook, but maybe because it is shared only on Gmail and Facebook. But if you share it on WhatsApp, you share it on other mediums also, all of this can give you a very good idea about which is working on the best for you. Now, for this particular example, Facebook, here the campaign visits on Facebook are more than Gmail, right? So now that I know that my Facebook is working out better for me, I will make sure ki mera, my promotional activities are better on Facebook and they are more on Facebook. I'll make sure I promote it there more than I promote it on Gmail or other medium. So that is one of the things that you will get. This is turning your donors into fundraising champions. Like I told you all before, you all, when you share a crowdfunding campaign with them, with any of your audience, with your friends, your family, anybody, they are a first-time donor for you. Okay, then when you send them family updates, thank you emails, emailers, anything, you send them tax exemption receipts and everything, they turn into a donor who would donate on regular basis, or because they probably trust you, your NGO and everything. So they turn into a recurring donor. And the last one is the campaigner. Now what happens here is, as I told you before, your campaigner could be probably anybody who would be like a regular donor, a supporter or anything. So your main target here should be ki your first donor, your donor who donates you for the first time, should convert into a campaigner. So you send them timely emails, thank you emails, updates, CEO, everything you keep sending them, keep in touch with them throughout the year, throughout your entire cycle, and turn them into a campaigner. Like for example, you can send emails through the Ketto dashboard based on how much the donors have donated. Okay, now if your donors have donated about a certain amount, for example, about 10,000 rupees, they have made a donation. You can send an email to all those donors that, hey, thank you so much for your generous contribution. It would be great if you could pull in more donors and create a crowdfunding campaign with us. You can target your donors likewise, but first they need to be a regular donor and then you can do this. So gradually, the main thing here is that you convert your first time donor into a campaigner and pull in few more donors through them also. Okay, so yeah, I think that's about it, and let's move on to any questions or anything that you have.
Hello, thank you, Ayushi. Guys, if you have any questions, you can type in your questions and then your questions should be displayed and answered.
Okay, hi Krishnaraj, right? So his question is, what are the Ketto fees for an NGO, right? So we have like a basic fee structure for every NGO, right? Which is 6%, which we charge for the portal, 3% is the payment gateway fee. And of course, GST is applicable, so which makes it 10.6%. The entire amount. So 10.6% is applicable on the amount that you have raised, not the whole amount. Okay. And apart from that, there are different kind of activities that also Ketto does. Like, you know, it could be probably running ads or anything, but it depends on the calls on a marketing team, what they're deciding. So there will be obviously a different structure for that. But the basic, which we follow for most of our NGOs, is this 10.6%, including GST. What does this mean? What does annual subscription fees mean? Can I get a clarity on that? Okay, I think what I'm guessing from this question is, if we charge anything, if an NGO signs up on Ketto, right, we don't really charge anything. The charge is only when you raise funds, and on the amount that 10.6% is charged, nothing, no fees for subscription or no fees for having an account on Ketto at all. Next question is, it was a great session. How many people get access to it? I'm sorry, I'm not actually understanding this question. What gateway? Hi Smita, actually I wanted to understand your question. Could you just rephrase it for me? Let's move on to the next question. And okay, Aditi, hi. So like I told you all that, you can't really force anybody to make donations, but the best thing that you can do is gain their trust, and that you can only do by sending them timely emails, updates, and sending a thank you email goes a long way. The donors like love to be acknowledged. They love to be, said that, hey, thank you so much for donating. They love to know what happened with the amount that they've donated. So I think, it is not necessary कि 100% आपके जो donors होंगे वो donate कर लेंगे वापस से, okay? But a lot of them will donate if you are sending them these thank you emails, very good ones, and the updates कि उनकी donation से क्या हुआ, they love that, and I think you can, that is the only way that you can retain your donors. Okay, the next question is, does the NGO have to be concerned? Hi, Guhan. No, the NGO does not have to be concerned about that at all. We have very good systems to, very secure they are. And we have been doing this for a very, very long time, like more than 6 years actually. And until now, we haven't gotten any complaints in terms of of the confidentiality of the data. So you don't really need to worry about that. The next one is, okay. I am not really understanding the question. In order to feed in the details of the donor, how many employees can feed the details at a time? Feed in the details of the donor, I think, Smita, see, I think the donor data, I think you're talking about the donor data which you get on the dashboard. The donor data is already, you already get the donor data when people start to donate. So when the donations are made, the information is captured and the list keeps, the list keeps increasing. And you get all that data automatically over there. You can download the data as a CSV and also upload the CSV files. I hope I have answered your question. If there is anything else that I've not covered, please let me know. Or you can even contact me later, like you have my email ID. And I'll share my contact number also with you if you are required. And we can get in touch later also. The next one is, when data receipts be sent on the donation as well? Okay. Hi, Sai Krishna. That's a very good question. See, what happens when the ATG receipts? Sometimes there is a sometimes people end up asking for a refund. That is a case which is very, it's like once in a blue moon almost. It's very negligible, but sometimes it happens. So suppose I am making a donation on your campaign, mujhe ATG receipt aa jata hai, theek hai? But then I ask for a refund, then that ATG receipts should not be technically with them, right? So that is why it depends on when the NGO wants to send an ATG receipt. It is very easy. It's just a click away. Okay. And if you want, if it is your requirement, we can make it automated also for you. And of course, your campaign manager will be there to help you with all the technical aspects from the Ketto dashboard. So you don't really need to worry about that. Okay, the next question. Apart from the access to the Ketto platform, continuing projects for fundraising, what is the support to the member NGOs? So, the Ketto, Ketto will provide you one thing. It provides you the platform. It provides you all those details which I took you through, like the contact details, the donor details, the sending emails, ATG, everything. And it will help you like create very long-term fundraising strategies, to get new one-third donor, convert the existing into the recurring donors. Everything will be done. And apart from that, we have a marketing team also who would love to promote your campaigns and everything on our social media who have like a very good amount of traffic. But it again depends on what is your cause, what is the kind of content, is your how unique is your content, your fundraiser, everything. So there are a lot of other things that Ketto provides you with. The next one is it okay for it? Okay, Guhan. Okay, so hi Guhan. It is not a very ideal way to crowdfund, because what happens is sometimes if I'm suppose creating a campaign on Ketto, okay, and I'm creating a campaign on another crowdfunding portal, if you try to share both of them, there is a possibility that some people might think one of it is genuine and one of it is not. One of it is fake. It has just been copied and, somebody else is trying to raise funds. And if you do that, since there is a trust issue, people might not end up donating at all on either of the campaigns. So I think it's not a very ideal thing to do if you want to keep the campaigner's trust and if you want to, raise funds. I think you need to stick to one platform only. Okay. The next one is it likely that the donor data of many NGOs can be shared across other clients, NGOs by Ketto? No, data can't be shared Just a second. Yeah. So, Guhan, again, we do not really share data with anybody because the NGOs have, it remains to the NGOs, they have a certain database and set of donors. And if we share that donor details, the donors also might get furious about it because the NGOs will start sending them emails and all of that. And it is against the policy, actually. We have certain terms and conditions. That's why we do not share such data with anybody. Like I told you before also, you don't really need to worry about the confidentiality. If we already have offline donors, how do we add them to the data? Okay. So, Smita, I got your question now. If you have offline donors, you can add few of them manually also, and you can upload a CSV file also. So it's very easy. Like if you have about 10 donors, you don't really need to manually add 10 donors to it manually. CSV file will also do. Thanks, Ron. Ideally, for how much duration the campaign should run? Okay. Ideally, a campaign should run for about 35 to 40 days. And there will be no sense of urgency and it too short, not enough time to reach the goal. Okay. So, you know, there is a freedom to be running a campaign for however long you want, but ideally it should not be running for a very long time because it makes no sense to, you know, push the same campaign again and again if it's not getting much traction. Okay. Does Ketto cater to both national and international funders? Okay, it depends on the NGO, of course. If they have an FCRA, even international donors can make donations. Otherwise, they cannot. We don't really support international funding if the Kettos don't have an FCRA. So I think that's about it. Is there somebody else who wants to ask anything? Hello, Amit. Hello. Yeah, Amit, I want you to enable the survey once for the NGOs so that, you know, they can give us a feedback and we could give them like a better experience. That's the survey is for completely. So I hope that all of you can spare at least just 1 minute of your time and complete the survey. Just click on the survey on the top, the red button, and just complete it. Thanks,
Rajiv. Hello. Thank you, everyone, for attending the webinar. Please fill in the survey that is displaying on the top in the red. and we will be sharing with you a few resources like the presentation which was done in webinar, and also we will be sharing you another resource which Ayushi is going to share.
Yeah.
What are the must do's for the organization to do a great crowdfunding campaign? And we will also be sharing a feedback platform with you all. And we hope to see you in all our webinars. Thank you. Thank you so much for it.
Thank you so much. Thanks a lot.
Thank you, Ayushi.
Thanks.